then it's the next best thing to a pot of gold.
It's the perfect little dessert after you've eaten all these little desserts.
Keep it tuned for St. Patty's Day party ideas.
It takes more than luck to make a great St. Patty's party. We've got some sensational ideas.
And this, by the way, is the hottest trend in food right now. Food on a stick.
Really?
Better, we'll be right back.
Plus, you don't have to be Irish to have a great party this St. Patrick's Day. Our party pro has tricks anyone can try.
Food coloring spray and a shamrock.
Better, we'll be right back.
Up next on Better.
From lucky cocktails to a shamrock buffet, we've got the festive and fun ways to throw the ultimate St. Patrick's party.
And we top it off with a little mint-flavored Bailey's cream.
Ooh, I love Bailey's. St. Patty's Day is right around the corner, so why not get in the spirit and start feeling the luck of the Irish today? Look, I am. Well, entertaining expert Mark Addison is here to help us all strike gold with some great ideas for a festive St. Patrick's Day party. And this is where I got this.
Yes.
Thank you, Mark.
And I have my own as well.
I know. I love that. And you actually say that in Ireland, they don't wear full green like
right.
we do here.
No, in Ireland, they don't wear green. They wear a spot of green mm-hmm. as a remembrance. So that can be done with a ribbon in your hair or a pin like we're wearing today. But, you know, there's a lot of great Irish traditions. And my grandmother, who is 100% Irish, Miss Rita O'Toole.
She taught
said,
you these?
Well, she did. She always said, you know, if you're lucky to be Irish, that's lucky enough. So I wanted to start off with something that is magical and Irish, and of course the shamrock mm-hmm. is the symbol of good luck. So I took these plain white plates and created a shamrock design that was so easy to do. I just used some color spray. It's a food coloring spray and a shamrock. Easy
How
to do.
Easy. I love
to do.
That. Does that wash off or will they stay
wash,
like
No,
that?
Washes off perfectly. And if you happen Perfect. To get your food on it, then you're eating green food. No worries at all. And then I wanted to make sure we paired it with another staple, which is a white napkin, mm-hmm. a white linen, and I created these little florets, which actually, going along with our green theme, if your guests didn't happen to wear green, wear or a spot
off.
Of green, it comes off, and now I'm going to add yet another spot of green to my outfit.
Perfect.
It's a
Love
spot
that.
Of green, a magical napkin.
Okay, so let's talk food.
Okay, food's great. Okay, so what I wanted to do is make sure we created a magical centerpiece of food, and of course, it's based off of good luck and the shamrock. So these are these green and blue mm-hmm. Irish balls. So it's actually a grape inside with blue cream cheese,
Ooh.
Which is an Irish cream cheese, has to be, and then rolled in pistachio nuts.
No,
absolutely delicious.
Delicious.
And this, by the way, is the hottest trend in food right now, food on a stick.
Really?
So hot. So hot at all celebrity parties.
Oh,
must
wow.
have. Next, we have another savory one, which I call the Irish meat pie. And, of course, it is done, again, with our shamrock
of
shape.
Of course.
And you bake them on the stick. They come out perfect just like this.
Okay.
Okay, crazy hot right now. Cake balls. And of course, cake balls on a stick, mm-hmm. even better. Now, even better, these are drunken cake balls because they're made with Guinness and they're made with Bailey's.
Ooh, we
and then
like
we
that.
Dip them in the green candy. We put a little extra green gold for
nice.
Luck.
Shamrock cookies? Those
these are not
too?
Cookies. These are actually called Blarney scones.
Oh, scones.
So it's a
okay,
scone,
scone on a stick.
But they're a Blarney, which is when you kiss the Blarney scone. It's a Blarney scone, so you can kiss them and then eat them.
So, Mark, it's time to talk drinks. I'm going to try one of these scones while you tell us about the wonderful drinks.
Well, first of all, we're going to start off with an actual dessert, which mm-hmm. is called the Irish milkshake. So it's made like a typical milkshake, but instead of a root beer, we're going to use stout beer. And
oh.
we have some Guinness stout. So you pour it in just like a regular, and we top it off with a little mint-flavored Bailey's cream.
Ooh, I love Bailey's.
It's so good. Mm-hmm. It's the perfect little dessert after you've eaten all these little desserts.
Okay.
But we also need to have some lucky cocktails. Mm-hmm. And we need to start with our lucky leprechaun.
Right here?
Yes, it's a green drink that's made with Midori and a little blue curacao to get that great green color. It's a great, refreshing drink. Who leads us to the lucky rainbow?
Uh-oh. Now, that one looks scary.
It's actually really good, but it's made with layered flavored vodka. So it's all vodka. You've got to be careful. Drink one layer at a time. And once you get down to the bottom of the rainbow, what it leads us to is the pot of gold.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Which is a great sparkling gold cocktail. It actually has 24 karat gold around the rim. Mm-hmm. And it has gold dust inside the vodka and a little bit of sparkling Prosecco. Keeps that gold dancing.
Oh, I love that. I would be passed out after one of these.
I recommend only one. Only one, because we don't want to do, you know,
Okay.
The bad St. Patrick's Day. This is a magical, happy St. Mm-hmm. Patrick's Day.
We want to have a good one. Okay, so while we're cheering, you
oh,
have one more.
I think we should have a toast.
thing from your grandmother?
Well, my grandmother always said, on the banister of life, may the staples be going in the opposite direction.
Oh, the Irish know what they're talking about.
Yes,
Thank you,
does.
Mark.
Mish and mish.